So around that time, it was not easy for them. She worked hard, deserved it to die. Aloys, in his studies in Europe, I've met many people, many of his friends who talk about the little scholarship they got. He did not take it and save and so on. He helped many people who came after him to study in Belgium, to show them around, to teach them the ropes, how to work and get also the graduate degrees. When he came back to Rwanda, he worked a little bit, and after 1 year he got married to Emma Uwimana. That was in 76. And soon after that, in 76, he was sent to Germany to work at the Rwandan embassy. So, 1980, that's when he was transferred to Belgium. That's when they had the first two teams, a Marvel and so Aloys excelled everywhere he worked. Aloys, he came back to Rwanda after Belgium, worked a few years. In 84, he was assigned as ambassador to Japan. He traveled many countries in the Southeast Asia, expressing Rwandan interest. And I talked to him. I know, I heard some of the things they've done, increasing import of Japanese cars to Rwanda. Many people don't know that. In the early 80s, the import of Japanese cars were increased in Rwanda. Japan gave facilities to the country to send us more cars. I remember my dad had a small Japanese car, and they were available because of many Rwandan representatives who worked hard in Tokyo, and he was one of them. He was the top, he was the ambassador. So, come to America in 1997. It was before many of us got to America, 87. So, he distinguished himself, he represented us, Rwandans, he was also assigned to Latin American countries. He sent Brazil, Argentina, was it also Mexico?
Mexico.
And Mexico. He traveled to all those towns, those countries. Aloys, Ambassador Uwimana. He is what I want to talk about him and his courage. This man has dined with the kings in Japan. I've seen a picture of him with Ronald Reagan, the hero of Republicans. Any Republicans here? Okay, I will not go there, I will not mention that. But Aloys has been to be a hero a number of times. And in the early, before 1990, he was always presented to the king. Now, one thing I really wanted to say today about Ambassador Aloys. Let me tell you, coming to America, 1992, that's when I came, I was on a scholarship. Somebody told me, call Ambassador Aloys. I was like, how do you call an ambassador? I am a little boy from the village. We had no traffic lights, we had a few cars to count. Call him. They gave me a phone, I called, and he picked up. And he told me, you are not Gary Shah. Remember that? He liked to say Shah when you are a young man, and he meant for behind it. This was a Gary Shah. No, I gave the mama guy. Then in a few weeks, I came to the US, went to school in North Carolina. I told him, he picked up. He's like, come visit me in Washington, D.C. I was still scared. I'm going to see the ambassador. The ambassador. I went to the Rwandan embassy and he told them there is a boy coming. Let him in. It was amazing to get. You've gone to many embassies. Some of you are from different countries. How many ambassadors you can go there and they say, let him in? It's like, let him in. When Church of Urban, he invited me to the house, and Emma, they really welcomed me. I ate, I drank, and I made it to my home. My vacation, my Christmas, my Thanksgiving. So that's how I connected to Aloys. When he went to his house, he's not the kind of man who will keep dairy cows in the cabinet somewhere. He's like, you tell me what you want to drink, you tell me what you want to eat. He was very
generous.
He was very generous. He did not have food or drinks for ambassadors and one for the kids from the village in Rwanda. He shared everything he got. And if you had a chance to sit with him, you had that sense. So the kind of he was a real man. So then again, in the name of the family, I want to invite all of you who remember him, who have some memories of him, who have crossed lives with him, and
hello. Now is Uwimana. Is according to father. So he was 10 years older than me. Here's this cap. Usually, things don't really have a lot of time. But I knew he was there. He disciplined us. When that was doing, he cared for us. And I remember when I went to middle school, I play around. I play cards, handmade cards under the table. What happened at the end of the year? Miss Asunta, you would have to repeat the year. So my brother was in early years at the University of Rwanda. He came and talked to the director of the school and he said, I know my sister is capable. Give her a chance and we do it. And she will do it. And he turned around and gave me that father's look. In English, we would say, you pick up your ass, otherwise. Well, so they promoted me to the second year. The rest is history because I picked up my ass. And I was in second class and third class, and that's when I met Claudine's mom as one of my favorite teachers. My brother was a very simple man. He cared for us, he gave us advice, he was an inspiration for school, he cared about school. Our father was a teacher, he always talked because he didn't have a degree, and then the people showed up, he was made up, labor. But, Aloys was a good student. He made friends very quickly. He was like a magnet. And he would come home when he was in college with all his friends, and they would sing all this song that was very funny about theater and other things. I remember some of those, but I can't sing those here in Aloys. And I remember the theater was always that I feel. When he went to Europe, he had to pass him, asking not to work, but giving us advice, making sure that we're doing what we're supposed to do. It was a very harmful man. Only 2 times I saw him, a little bit upset. With that first time when I did bad in school, the second time I was late for something. It was probably saying that he was a very punctual person. So I don't know the time.
Just moving around in these states. So when it comes to the talk about the Washington issue, I for some reason I called at the embassy.
Her family was a friend of mine. We used to live together. I never knew
that showed the system of humanity. And after that, we're living with when as soon as I came to South North Carolina, I found out that she was a smooth. Somehow they didn't trust me. We have found something funny. We know Emma. And what you can tell to them is that we know that Uwimana is now the king of peace. And what people are trying to pay for the family is that the role of being with them. But my name is Kinalo Matata. I'm not going to say too much because most of the stuff other people have said it. So, but I'm going to only just tell you how simple this guy Aloys was. I learned how to, I didn't know him when I was in the country, but when I got here, really, I realized that it was really, really, very, very simple. You know, one of the ways I can tell you, when he was in North Carolina, only 12 years, you know, where I came, you come in the United States, when you had two houses, and, you know, at the end of the day, you know, we did not have anywhere where to sleep. We would crash in the living room, and then we would only have the living room for granted. So that's, I remember him sleeping in my living room, like that. And that's how simple he was. He was really very, very simple, you know, and he imagined that he him really just. Somebody who's an ambassador, you know, just coming to ask where are the refugees, you know, here for a few months, you know, a few years, you know, that he will just come in, just level himself to us. So that's really something I will never remember to forget. Another thing is, you know, he was, he sat me down, it is like a, you know, we were, you see these roads, you know, we were driving and get lost. He really taught me how to use the atlas. You know, he started me, you know, for 30 minutes, you know, draw these lines, you know, he's like, you know, if you try to go to this address, this is how you figure out how to get there. You know, that's, you know, every time I'm like, you know, I look at the Google map, I just remember Ray's teaching me how to use the atlas. Yeah, so using my Google map or my Waze, you know, things like that. So if it wasn't about it, you know, I could have like, you know, slept in the cars, you know, many nights. So, you know, maybe really, this guy, you know, I mean, unfortunately, we didn't spend enough time with him because, you know, things changed in the neighborhood area. But the time I spent with him, he really, you know, I just learned how to, I wish I can be as simple as how it was. May God.
When she got to Belgium, she was a little grown, and her mom told her
there is an uncle from the US who is coming to see her.
Je pouvais pas m'imaginer qu'elle oncle. Ah mais de côté de ton grand-père. Ah bon? Mon grand-père, est-ce qu'il a une famille? C'est ça que je me suis posé en question. Avant que je finisse lundi, c'est un ambassadeur. Ah bon? Alors, je me suis imaginé quelqu'un de grand et de costaud. Dites-moi comment on me parlait. Il était en difficulté.
Okay. Continue,
excuse-moi, tu te sens très fort. Et puis, quand j'arrive, il était avec moi, sa famille, les enfants de l'occasion de le voir, sa famille, et le père est comme ça. Je n'ai même pas si grand comme ça. Je n'ai pas parlé beaucoup. On a discuté, on est parlé, on a posé des questions sur les études. Je suis parti, je me suis fini, j'étais mon bac, j'étais reconnaissant.
Thank you for the good work.
Yeah.
There we go.
Yay.
There we go.
Okay.